So we're excited to be working with the Greater Washington Partnership to convene a discussion around HBCUs as catalyst for regional inclusive economic growth and the role that Howard University plays in fostering inclusive economic development. Howard has been an institution in DC since 1867. We've grown from a single-story frame building to more than 250 acres in three wards of the city and a campus in Beltsville, Maryland. With about 5,000 employees and a payroll of $400 million, we have a tremendous economic impact on DC and the region, over $1 billion. Deputy Mayor, given that context, how do you see leveraging universities with the district to help build the city's robust and inclusive economic development strategy?
I think there are so many opportunities for universities to be collaborating with cities. When we look at what our future economic development pipeline and program is, it really relies on the continued attraction and retention of talent. And Howard University is one of the seven major universities in DC that puts us on the map in terms of where students want to go. And so it's our job to keep them here so that they can become entrepreneurs, so that they can work for businesses here and they start to build a family and reside here. But there's other ways that universities also support the city. And it has to do with how you manage your campus. Are you a campus that's inward looking and closed off to the rest of the city, or are you integrated? And Howard has done a tremendous job of really being outward looking and expanding so that the university campus footprint isn't just limited to students and faculty, but it really helps support local economic development. I think that economic development in the city has always relied on a base of what I call feds, eds, and meds. And Howard represents two of those underpinning pillars, education, and you are growing as a university. You just told me a few moments ago about how your student base has even grown dramatically since you joined in this job. And then in terms of meds, your hospital obviously having a huge impact in the city as well and its employment base. So there are multiple ways that universities in general contribute to a city. But Howard University in particular, because of the medical component, has a huge opportunity to partner and to contribute to the economy as well.
I'm glad you mentioned the external connections that the universities have with their cities. So for example, 50,000 patients came through our ER last year. We're one of the top producers of STEM PhDs in the country for minority students. So we really are anchored to this community in ways that are really important and that really become, like you mentioned, a source of leverage and economic development strategy for this community.
Also say we hadn't talked very much about inclusivity, which is part of what this forum is about today. And what is the role of an HBCU in that context? I think that Howard University has a tremendous legacy, not only as a historically black college, but as a black college that produces some of the greatest names in African American history that represent academic excellence. We are, DC is, a historically black city. And so when we think about our future economic growth, we think a lot about how that inclusivity and diversity welcomes, attracts, retains people who have talent, who have vision, who are investing. And I think that there's great opportunity for partnership between Howard and the District of Columbia because of this unique identifier that we share.
Yeah, I think it's a real source of competitive advantage.
Yeah, in terms of what we are seeing now, we are seeing that businesses owned by people of color are moving to DC because they're seeking an economy that is inclusive, that understands what they need, where they're among like-minded people, where they're among like community people. And so we want to lean into that. And I think it is, as we look to the future, reasons that people will move to Washington is to be part of that. I'll extend that way beyond just thinking about black entrepreneurs. The tech community writ large wants that dynamic diversity of ideas and innovation, and that comes from everywhere. And so we're seeing that there's growth in our tech sector for any number of reasons, but among them is the diversity and inclusivity of our economy. Rashad, I think a lot about how multiple developments impact the overall economic landscape of the city, but could you tell me from your perspective, what is the role of your anchor institution? How do you think about growth? And how do you think about your impact on your local economy?
That's such a great question, because I think that we really serve as an anchor institution in two critical ways. One is around our development and what we do around our development. At Howard, we really view economic development as a placemaking opportunity. Not only are we building, for example, three new academic buildings on our campus for the benefit of our faculty, staff, and students to give them modern 21st century learning spaces, but we're also partnering with the private development community to create mixed-use developments in the Georgia Avenue corridor. So when you think about that, think about new market-rate housing, for example, new commercial spaces, amenity-based spaces that will not only benefit our faculty, staff, and students on the campus, but benefit the community writ large, whether it's Pleasant Plains or the Shaw community, for example. So we're really about creating those place-making, defining economic development projects that really add value to the whole community. Not only does it create jobs for construction workers, for full-time workers, but it creates a sense of community and renovation and rejuvenation for the community that we sit in. So that's very important. Beyond the economic development projects that we have and the investment and the job creation that comes from that, we're also an anchor institution from the way that we service our community. For example, the School of Social Work spent 50,000 hours last year working with nonprofits in supporting their mission and activity and work as a living learning lab for our students. The law clinic at our law school served hundreds of clients in pro bono cases, for example. The med school and all of our health sciences programs worked so hard during the COVID pandemic, vaccinating thousands of DC residents. And you think about sort of the medical enterprise as well. Howard University produces Black doctors, nurses, pharmacists, and dentists. Without our pipeline of producing undergraduates that go on to health science programs all across the country, not to mention the health science programs in Howard University, we wouldn't have the number of Black physicians and healthcare workers that we do. So we're a really important part of this national ecosystem of developing culturally competent, diverse talent in any number of fields. I like to tell people, with our 14 schools and colleges, we train individuals, the best and the brightest, in just about every field of human endeavor. That's an awesome responsibility to have as an institution, and it's such a critical role that we play, not only in DC and the region, but also nationally in that regard. Deputy Mayor, as an anchor institution, how can we work in greater partnership with the District of Columbia on this inclusive prosperity economic development strategy?
Well, as you know, we're already doing a lot of the good things that not only an anchor institution should be doing with the district, but as one of our primary universities in the district, I think that we're doing already. We're doing some placemaking, although I think we could do more of it, just because you're going to be going through a period of growth. And I think that that Georgia Avenue corridor, when you think about it, it connects directly to 7th Street, which is our Gallery Place, Chinatown, and downtown area. So there's something there where we invite people to Gallery Place, Chinatown, they get to experience it. But then if they really want to discover DC, and they want to know the real DC, and they want to know the real Howard, and they want to know the real people, they come up Georgia Avenue. And what are they greeted by? They get to know U Street, Black Broadway. They get to know Howard as an institution and as a contributor. There's something there that's really special and unique to Washington, DC, that's all built on the foundation of what Howard has institutionally and historically meant, but also what it will be. The other area of partnership that I think is really exciting to me as we try and pivot away and grow and diversify our economy, that we could be partnering together, where Howard has a very unique profile. Howard, to me, is the center of Black excellence in the district, not just in the district, but in the nation. And so I'm really interested in what being a center of Black entrepreneurship means for the District of Columbia, to be that for the nation, to be one of those core areas that if you are an entrepreneur, that's a person of color, that you come here first to start your business, to grow your business, to invest. That is where there's great opportunity for partnership. The country is looking for a model that works, that's sustainable, that's based on the talent and the skill set and the prospect, and not based on other elements or you know, kind of moralities. It's really about the people and the talent that they bring. And so that's another area of partnership that we could really lean into, and I think not only compete, but excel.
You know, that entrepreneurship piece is so important. So we recently started the PNC Center for Entrepreneurship that's really focused on cultivating Black entrepreneurship, not only in DC, but through a network of HBCUs across the country. It's a point, another point of competitive advantage and leverage for us. We also have our Small Business Development Center located in our School of Business that today gives thousands of hours of technical assistance to entrepreneurs, to businesses, to really find that route to access to capital and find those routes to good partnerships where they can grow and develop their business. I think we've got a tremendous opportunity working with the district, just in making sure that we're inclusive in our contracting and leveraging all the things I know the district is doing to ensure inclusive contracting and minority participation in contracts across the gamut. Whether it's from our $800 million capital plan, where we're going to be focused on renovating those academic buildings I mentioned earlier, or our $1 billion development plan for all of those private partnership projects that we've got in commercial real estate areas that we're going to be focused on. I think those are real opportunities where we can come together, business, the district, the university, to make those gains and those impacts. The other area I think that we really have an opportunity to partner on is around attracting new industry. And you mentioned it a couple of times of how people are flocking to DC and want to be in DC. We've had $106 million in sponsored research last year. It's the most that we've had in our history. And we've got researchers that are really making groundbreaking discoveries and creating new knowledge in all kinds of areas, but doing it through an equity-based lens, whether it's AI or big data or health disparities, for example, or our STEM researchers, or even humanities researching research efforts. There are real opportunities to leverage that into business growth and development in the district. So I'm excited to be working with the district and with you and your agency on how we can bring meaningful contributions and growth to what we're doing in DC.
When I think about inclusive growth and sustainable inclusive growth, I think about three ingredients. Number one, and you mentioned it, contracting. There has to be a stable and reliable source of contracts that new businesses or businesses that are trying to move from small to medium or medium to large can rely on, because there's a commitment from the District of Columbia, from major institutions like Howard and others, that they have opportunity. Number two, technical assistance. Knowing that as businesses are looking to start up any phase of their journey or they're trying to grow, that there's going to be that ecosystem that supports that business in the growth technically of their business. And then three is access to capital. You mentioned it. And again, I think that we, Howard and the District of Columbia together, have an incredible opportunity to be the home for capital that's committed to inclusive economic growth. And how do we harness that for the country, frankly? So I'm really excited about partnership. I'm excited about the future of Howard University. I'm excited about the future of the District of Columbia. And I think we've got the best is yet to come, as they say.
Couldn't have said it better. Thank you.
A HU.
You know?